G'day! In this video, we will learn the distributive law. This is also called expanding and factorizing expressions in parentheses. It sounds complicated, but it's actually quite easy. First, we will learn how to expand expressions. Here is a basket with two apples and one banana. Let's write that in algebra. We write A for apple and B for banana. So 2 apples and 1 banana is 2a plus 1b. What happens when there are 3 of these baskets? Altogether, that's 6 apples and 3 bananas. How do we write that in algebra? Well, we use parentheses. One basket has 2 apples and 1 banana, so we write parentheses around these. There are 3 baskets, so we multiply that by 3 to get a total of 6 apples and 3 bananas. Look closely. Instead of counting, we can multiply each thing inside the parentheses by the 3 outside. So 2 apples, or 2a, multiplied by 3 is 6 apples, or 6a. And 1 banana, or 1b, multiplied by 3 is 3 bananas, or 3b. We just used the distributive law to expand the expression in parentheses. That was easy, wasn't it? What happens when there are 4 baskets and each basket has 3 apples and 2 bananas? Altogether, that's 12 apples and 8 bananas. Let's write that in algebra. 3 apples and 2 bananas are in one basket. That's 3a plus 2b in parentheses. There are 4 baskets, so we multiply that by 4. We multiply each thing inside the parentheses by the 4 outside. So 3a multiplied by 4 is 12a, or 12 apples. And 2b multiplied by 4 is 8b, or 8 bananas. A carnival gives away show bags. Each show bag has 2 balls and 3 kites. What's in 3 bags? That's 2 balls, or 2b, plus 3 kites, or 3k in parentheses, all multiplied by 3. 2b times 3 is 6b, and 3k times 3 is 9k. Altogether, that's 6 balls and 9 kites. What happens if there are 1 monkey and lots of bananas? A big mess. Just joking. Okay, now, let's get serious. Algebra is really mathematical patterns that use variables, that's the letters, to represent numbers, not apples and bananas. We will now expand expressions just using algebra. Let's expand 2f minus 1g in parentheses multiplied by 3. In this example, we must be careful when working with negative signs. Let's expand. Positive 2f times positive 3 is positive 6f, and negative 1g times positive 3 is negative 3g. The answer is 6f minus 3g. This is correct, but in algebra the multiplying number is usually written in front of the parentheses, like this. Also, this multiply sign is usually not written, and the one in front of the g is usually not written. Expand negative 3 times 2a plus b in parentheses. In this example, notice that the multiplier is a negative number. Also remember that there is a 1 in front of the b. To expand, negative 3 times 2a is negative 6a, and negative 3 times 1b is negative 3b. The answer is negative 6a minus 3b. Expand d times 2a plus b in parentheses. In this example, the multiplier is the variable d. Also, remember that there is a 1 in front of the b. So d times 2a is 2dA, and d times 1b is 1dB. In algebra, we don't write the 1, and the letters are usually written in alphabetical order, like this. So the final answer is 2AD plus BD. Expand A times A plus B in parentheses. Here is another example where the multiplier is a variable. A times A is A squared, and A times B is AB. The answer is a squared plus ab. Now we will learn to factorise expressions. Factorising is the reverse of expanding. Remember in our example with apples and bananas, we expanded 3 times 2a plus b in parentheses to get the answer of 6a plus 3b. Well, factorising is the reverse of expanding, like this. When we factorise, we start with 6a plus 3b and work out what multiplying number would go in front of the parentheses, and then what will be inside the parentheses. Let's do an example. Factorise 2a plus 2b. What factor that is common to both 2a and 2b can go in front of the parentheses? It's 2. So 2 times what equals 2a? It must be a. And 2 times what equals 2b? It must be b. Let's do another example. Factorise 6a plus 15b. What is a factor of both 6a and 15b that could go in front of the parentheses? It's 3. So 3 times what equals 6a? It must be 2a. And 3 times what equals 15b? It must be 5b. Factorise negative 6a minus 15b. This example is similar to the last example, except that it has 2 negative signs. Here, the largest factor that goes in front of the parentheses is negative 3. So negative 3 times what equals negative 6a? It must be positive 2a. And negative 3 times what equals negative 15b? It must be positive 5b. Let's factorise f squared plus 3f. The factor that's common to both f squared and 3f is f. So f times what equals f squared? It must be f. And f times what equals 3f? It must be 3. Our final example is to factorise 2h squared plus 6h. The multiplier that goes in front of the parentheses is both a number and a variable. It's 2h. So 2h times what equals 2h squared? It must be h. And 2h times what equals 6h? It must be 3. Thank you for watching this video.